Hi everyone, it's Gege here and welcome to Be Colorful! Today we continue to create cards with the Tonic Craft Kit 41. In particular, we will make a shaker card using mixed media techniques. It will be a graffiti style card, very suitable for young boys and girls. So let's move on to the work surface right away to create card number 11. First, I'm gonna prepare the card base on 300 GSM white cardstock. It will be a standard size card that's 5 by 7 inches. I usually use the American A2 size, that is 4 1/4 by 5 1/2, but the dice in this ice cream shaker kit are quite large, so if I want to give the background a little more space too, I think the 5 by 7 inches is more suitable for that. Okay, next I'm gonna create the 4 3/4 by 6 3/4 background panel, again on white cardstock. As you can see, it is slightly smaller than the card base, so I will get some finishing edges, which I always like to have on my card. Well, now let's create a DIY background. One technique I really like is to swipe an ink pad directly onto the paper. If you make straight movements in one direction, you get a beautiful effect similar to the grain of the hood. To vary the intensity of the color, calibrate the pressure of the ink pad. The harder the pressure, the more color you will spread. To mark slightly thicker lines, rub only one edge of the ink pad. Then, if we also want to define some darker veins, we can simply introduce a darker color. The hood effect background would be fine like this, but to be perfect, I recommend this very simple technique. Create wooden planks. So I'm gonna cut out the panel into strips of paper. The cut must be parallel to the veins created. Then I'm going to cut out each strip into small rectangles. This time the cut must be perpendicular to the grain. See how it is taking shape. The final touch is to darken up the edges by applying the ink with a blending sponge. I think I'm gonna use the darker blue ink because this is too light, in my opinion. And I'd like more marked and defined edges. Okay, the planks are ready. Now I'm going to reassemble the panel by gluing them on another panel of the same size as the original. Perfect! I love the wooden planks effect. Before moving on to the background, I cut out a 4¾ by 6¾ inches panel on navy blue paper, which will create the finishing edges. I slightly shrink the background panel and then define the edges with dark blue ink. Now let's move on to adding some interest to the background using different mediums. So let's start using some mixed media techniques. First, I'm going to put a few sparkles of Nuvo Shimmer powder, a powder with pigments of various colors. In this case, a mix of magenta, purple, and blue, and with a metallic finish, very bright. To activate the pigment, you can use just water. Another mixed media technique is the random stamp to add interest to the background. In this case, I'm gonna stamp some stains here and there with clear ink. They are coffee stains, but they can be paint stains, perfect for a graffiti style. I'm using a clear ink because, as you may have already guessed, I'm going to heat embossing with the pastel yellow embossing powder included in the kit. Before continuing to add details in the background, I proceed to die cut the ice cream shake window using the medium die of the set. After that, I show you another technique widely used in mixed media project, the stencil technique. I'm gonna use the lilac glazier paste included in the kit, a very soft texture paste with silver microflakes. It is very shiny. I pick up and spread the paste with the lower part of the spatula. As you can see, I select only some portions of the stencil, covering some random points of the background. And here is the background totally created by us, by using in a card the techniques that are usually used in the mixed media project, such as art journal, tag, or canvas. And now let's move on to the focal point. That will be a shaker ice cream. First, I'm going to die cut the outlines of the ice cream onto the lilac classic card. Then I'm gonna die cut the stick out of craft paper. And as a background for the stick, I'm going to use lilac paper again, staining it with a touch of glazier paste. Still on lilac paper, I'm going to die cut the base of the ice cream. Then, with a violet ink, I'm going to create a shadow area on the bottom of the ice cream, blending the color with a blending tool. Finally, I'm gonna create the icing of the ice cream, die cutting on white cardstock with the appropriate die of the kit. For a nice glossy glaze, I decided to do a heat embossing on the whole figure. Then I dab the paper well with some clear ink, and I'm going to emboss it with the pastel yellow embossing powder of the kit. I melt the powder and I repeat the same process one more time. In this way, I'm gonna obtain a much more uniform and thick embossing. Okay, now I'm going to glue the blister on the back of the background panel. Then fill it with a mix of confetti. I remove the protective film of the adhesive located on the back of the blister and I close the area with the ice cream base. Just to be frugal, I'm going to remove the middle part of the navy blue panel, which will be covered by the background panel. And now I'm ready to assemble the card. I'm going to cover the empty spaces with some leftover pieces of cardstock so as not to have differences in thickness between the various layers of paper. Finally, I'm going to glue the ice cream. Let's move on to the sentiment, for which I'm gonna use the stamp that says "Stay jolly, have a lolly." I'm going to print it on white cardstock with the Onyx Black VersaFine ink. Then I heat set it with the clear embossing powder. I divide this sentiment into two parts, leaving just a small white border around the writing and cutting one off the end with an oblique cut. Then I'm adding some finishing edges with a navy blue paper. I'm going to finish the card by creating drops here and there with the Lilac Nuvo Vintage Drop included in the kit. And here we are at the end of this video. I really enjoy using mixed media techniques and I hope you can have fun applying these ideas on your cards. I like to use a lot of mediums and various techniques on a project. The final result is always satisfying for me because it gave me full freedom to all my creativity. Let me know in the comments if you also apply mixed media techniques on the card and if you like the effect you get. I thank you for watching this video and I'll see you at the next video for the last card I created with this kit. I give you a clue on the subject for the next card. I love it. I really hope you like the next card. For now, thank you all. Bye bye. See you next time and be colorful.